Hi friends, I am Balaji Rao. Welcome to BR Max class. In this class, we will learn domain, range and graph of sine function. Have patience, watch this video till the end. I am going to give detailed explanation of domain and range and graph of sine function. You observe this sine theta, here two things are there. One is theta, another one is sine theta. One is theta, another one is sine theta. For example, theta is 30 degrees. Sine 30 degrees is 1 by 2. Two things are there. One is 30 degrees, another one is 1 by 2. If I take theta is 30 degrees, sine 30 degrees is 1 by 2. So here two things are there. One is theta values, another one is sine theta values. So here I'll consider the sine theta values as y. Let y equal to sine theta. Now, we will try to understand what is domain range first, then we will come to know what is the domain of sine theta and what is the range of sine theta. For what values of theta, the function sine theta is defined is called domain of this function. For what values of theta, the function sine theta is defined is called domain of the function. For example, theta equal to 30 degrees. Sine 30 degrees is defined or not? Yes. Theta equal to 90 degrees. Sine 90 degrees is defined or not? Yes. Theta equal to 1000 degrees. Sine 1000 degrees is defined or not? Yes. So like that, for what values of theta, the function sine theta is defined, that is called domain of this function. Now, we will try to know what is range of the function. What values y gives for respect to theta values is called range. What values this y gives for respect to theta values is called range. For example, respect to theta values, if you take theta is 30 degrees, sine 30 degrees is 1 by 2, that means y is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 will be there in the range of this function. Suppose if I take theta is 90 degrees, sine 90 degrees is 1, that means y equal to 1, that means 1 will be there in the range of this function. Try to understand what is domain of the function. For what values of theta this function sine theta is defined, that is called domain of this function. What values this sine theta gives, that means what values this y gives for respect to theta values is called range of this function. For all real values of theta, sine theta is defined. For all real values, you take any real value, sine theta is defined. For example, sine 1, yes, it is defined. We can calculate sine 1 value. Sine 1 degree, yes, we can calculate sine 1 degree. Sine 30 degrees. Sine 1 crore degrees, yes, all those things are defined. However, while drawing the graph of sine theta, I'll explain these things more clearly. Sine function is defined for all the real numbers. Sine 1 crore degrees, yes, it is defined. Sine 10 pi, yes, it is defined. Sine 1000 pi, yes, it is defined. So, sine function is defined for all real numbers. So, what is the domain of this function? Domain of this sine function is all real numbers. Domain of sine function is all real numbers. Now, we will try to find what is range of sine function. You observe this diagram. In this diagram, if we rotate the initial ray, you observe here this green color one. If I rotate the initial ray through an angle theta, here theta is acute angle, then the OP is formed. If we took the coordinates of point P as x, y, then OQ is x, PQ is y, then the sine function is defined as y by r. Now, we will try to find what values this y by r gives. You observe triangle OPQ is a right angle triangle. In a right angle triangle, hypotenuse is the greatest side. That means r is greater than y because hypotenuse is the greatest side. R is greater than y. Is there any chance that this r value is same as y? Yes, possibility is there. You observe this. This is the initial ray, na? I rotate it through 90 degrees. Now, you observe what is this point? This point is on y-axis and y-axis x coordinate is 0 and 0, y. Y means this length is y. Actually, this length is radius of the circle also. Please try to understand. This length is y because this point is 0, y. This length is y, and of course, this is radius of the circle also. That means there is a chance that r equal to y. R is greater than or equal to y. We can write like this also. Y is less than or equal to r. It can be understood easily. See here, 3 is greater than or equal to 2. It means that 2 is less than or equal to 3 only. So r is greater than or equal to y means y is less than or equal to r. Now you divide with r on both sides as r is positive. Y by r will be less than or equal to 1. I divided both sides by r. Y by r is less than or equal to 1. Is it clear? Here, as we rotated theta as acute angle, x and y both are positive. Is there any chance that this y value is negative? If this terminal ray is in third quadrant or in fourth quadrant, y coordinate is negative. That means you will get this relation also, minus y by r less than or equal to 1. I hope you are understanding. Now what I'll do here, this inequality you multiply with minus. For an inequality, if we multiply with negative number, inequality changes. You multiply with negative number, multiply with minus 1, what you will get? You will get that y by r is greater than or equal to. I am multiplying with minus. When we multiply with negative real number in inequality, inequality changes. Less than changes to greater than or equal to. When I multiply with minus here, minus of minus will become plus y by r greater than or equal to minus 1. Y by r greater than or equal to minus 1 means this can be written as minus 1 less than or equal to y by r. So finally what you got here, you got that y by r is less than or equal to 1 and minus 1 less than or equal to y by r. So finally I'll conclude here. Please observe this carefully. What I got from this minus 1 less than or equal to y by r, which is less than or equal to 1. So here what I can write here, minus 1 less than or equal to, what is y by r? Y by r is sine theta. Sine theta is less than or equal to 1. That implies minus 1 less than or equal to sine theta. Sine theta, we consider sine theta as y. Minus 1 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 1. You observe here, what is the range we discussed? For what values y gives for respect to theta values is called the range. So y values are in between minus 1 and plus 1. There is a chance of minus 1 and there is a chance of plus 1. Therefore, what is the range of sine function? Range of sine function is closed interval minus 1, 1. I hope you are understanding. Now we will see the graph of sine function. You observe this graph of sine theta. I consider some theta values in between minus 2 pi to plus 2 pi. As the domain of this function is all real numbers, we cannot write all the values of real numbers. So I consider some values in between minus 2 pi to plus 2 pi. From the trigonometry table, we know sine 0 degrees value. Sine 0 degrees value is 0. Sine pi by 2. Sine pi by 2 value is 1. Sine pi value is 0. All those things we learn from trigonometry table. Sine 3 pi by 2 value is minus 1. However, I did all these proofs also. Why sine pi by 2 value is 1? Why sine 3 pi by 2 value is minus 1? All the proofs I did, you can check those videos also. Sine 2 pi value is 0. Sine of minus pi by 2. We know that sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So sine of minus pi by 2 is minus sine pi by 2. So this value will be minus 1. Sine of minus pi value is 0. Sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So finally, sine of minus 3 pi by 2 value is 1. So sine of minus 2 pi value is 0. So by keeping all these values, if I draw the graph looks like this. You please observe this graph. As sine 0 degrees value is 0, look here, this is sine 0 degrees. Sine 0 degrees value is 0, that means 0, 0. Sine pi by 2, sine pi by 2 value is 1. Here you observe, this is 1. Sine pi by 2 value is 1. Sine pi value again 0. You observe, this is pi, 0, the point pi, 0. Sine 3 pi by 2 value minus 1 as minus 1. You please observe here, 3 pi by 2 value minus 1. Sine 2 pi value 0. Similarly, this side also, if you mark the values, you will get like this. If you join all those points, you observe this is a wave form. It looks like a wave. It is important to remember this graph because in trigonometry, so many competitive problems can be done very easily if you know the graph of the function. It is important to memorize the graph of this function. The graph looks like a curve's form. This curve passes through 0, 0. So this is the graph of sine function. Here you observe, if we continue this graph like this, it keep on going like this. If we draw like this, it keep on going like this. So for all the real numbers, sine function is defined. You observe here, I said that domain of the sine function is all real numbers. For all the real numbers, we can draw the graph. And what is the range of sine function? Range of the sine function, we got it as closed interval -1, 1. You observe here, this graph does not exceed this range. You observe here, whatever theta value you take, respect to sine value is in between -1 and +1 only. Please try to understand. The graph is in between -1 and +1 only. You are not getting graph in this area and you are not getting graph in this area. That means whatever real x value you take, the function lies in between -1 and +1 only. That's why range of sine function is closed interval -1, 1. So finally, I'll conclude what we learned in this class. We learned that domain of sine function is all real numbers. Range of sine function is closed interval -1, 1. And we learned the graph of sine function. It is important to memorize this graph.